Welcome on, everyone. And I know it usually doesn't show, אבל אני באמת מתרגש. Really, like, you know, I usually don't show it, but so, dear Professor Hanna Wirth-Nesher, Professor Ra'anan Ryan, Vice President of Tel Aviv University, Professor Leo Kari, Dean of the Humanities, our distinguished keynote speakers, Professors Marilyn Reisbaum, Jonathan Friedman, David Roskies, dear colleagues, students, friends, I'm happy and honored to and delighted to open this very special symposium celebrating the work and many achievements of our dear colleague, mentor, teacher and friend, Professor Hanna Wirth-Nesher. I think it won't be an exaggeration to say, I really do mean this, that more than anyone else, and that I know, Hanna, how important the history of the department is to you. I think that more than anyone else in our department's rich history, Hanna has been and remains the heart and soul of our department, serving as our moral, creative, and inspirational compass in setting a mark of scholarly excellence and integrity we all aspire to, and which defines the work we do in the department that has come to be known under Hanna's guidance and vision as the Department of English and American Studies. It is hard to capture, and I'm sure this will be unfolding through the day, in a few sentences, the rich and a reach, actually, I meant to say, and depth and richness of Hanna's groundbreaking work in so many intersecting and yet distinct fields, as indeed reflected in, by today's rich symposium program, whether in the history and the theory of the modern and modernist novel, in her book City Codes, or in the literary and linguistic makeup of the Jewish American identity, a field which Hanna has not only come to be known as a world authority in, but a field rather that Hanna has helped shape and put on the map and make it what it is now through such landmark publications as the Cambridge Companion to Jewish American Literature, which she co-edited with Michael Kramer, and more recently, the Cambridge History of Jewish American Literature, or again, not least, in building from the ground up the study of Yiddish literature. I'm thinking, of course, the a very important issue on poetics today on Yiddish and language through her important work as director of the Goldreich Family Institute for Yiddish Language, Literature, and Culture. But for me personally, Hanna has been first and foremost an inspiring teacher, in the true meaning of both words, teacher and inspiring. And I'm sure I speak for many of her students in this room today when I note the very special way in which Hanna always communicates to her students, many of whom have the honor now, like me, of calling ourselves her colleagues, her deeply humane and profoundly wise love for and curiosity about the written word and its art. And by that, I precisely don't mean just English literature. I mean the written word in its widest possible sense. And I want to take this opportunity, Hanna, for me personally, to wish you for me and in the name of all of us, many, many more years of intellectual curiosity and passionate productivity in your ongoing love with English letters, which we all find so inspiring. So, Hanna, thank you. Also, we have to say some thank yous for making today possible. I'd like to thank Professor Shirley Sharon Zisser and Professor Milet Shamir for organizing this important symposium, and to our secretary Sigalit Shual and Omer Friedman, who did all the hard work that made this possible. And now, without further ado, I'd like to invite Professor Ra'anan Ryan, Vice President of Tel Aviv University, to say a few words, please.
Thank you, Noam. Shalom. Good morning. I take great pleasure in welcoming you all to this event, or should I say this celebration, honoring our friend and colleague, Professor Hannah Wirth-Nesher, or as we call her here, Hannah Wirth-Nesher. Hannah is supposedly retiring now, although, as we all know her, she will remain as active as always. Still, any excuse for celebration is a good one, especially as it brings together many of her former students. From my own experience, I know how proud you are not only of our own achievements, not only of the shelf with our own books, but also of the achievements of our former students, of the shelf with the books and articles published by the students who tend to be our colleagues, in this case, for example, Noam and Hannah. I guess I should probably start my brief remarks with stating the dry facts, quote unquote. Hannah is professor of English and American Studies at our university, the Samuel and Perry Haber Chair on the Study of the Jewish Experience in the United States, and the director of the Goldrich Family Institute for Yiddish Language, Literature, and Culture. She has written and edited many books and very many essays on American English and Jewish American writers. Recently, as you mentioned, Noam, we celebrated the publication of the Cambridge History of Jewish American Literature that she edited. Time and again, however, I'm surprised by how little do the academic CVs and list of publications tell us about the people behind them. Hannah is not just an excellent academic. We all know how important are her scholarly achievements as an author. We all know how important is her contribution to the academic community of researchers on Jewish American experiences as a mentor, editor, or reviewer. We all know how important is her service to this university in the various positions she has held. But Hannah is first and foremost an intellectual and a mensch with deep commitments to Jewish, Zionist, and humanistic causes. Israel, as you all know, is going through a struggle over its collective identities, and we all need intellectuals like Hannah, whose commitment to the values of pluralism, tolerance, and the respect for the other are as firm, her commitments are as firm as her Jewish and Zionist identities. Unfortunately, all too often, we hear populist politicians here and elsewhere pronouncing xenophobic and racist ideas and threatening liberal democratic values such as free speech and the rights of minorities. I'm not a literary scholar, nor am I an expert in Jewish North American experiences, but as a historian who has worked on Jewish experiences in South America, I've always found Hannah's work fascinating as it deals with the mosaic of Jewish identities and the fluidity, contextual, and performative nature of these hybrid identities. Hannah's scholarly enterprise has given voice to individuals and groups who had received little attention in the historiography, highlighted the multilingual experiences of immigrants, and emphasized gender aspects, memory issues, and the transatlantic nature as well of these experiences. So I would like to congratulate you, Hannah, on a very impressive career, and express my gratitude, our gratitude, for your contribution to this university. Thank you so much.